That's a terribly sad day for K-pop and Hallyu. Jonghyun, one of the five members of K-pop group SHINee, passed away on Monday evening, leaving fans in shock across the globe.
Singer and actress Sulli, a former member of the K-pop girl band FX, was found dead Monday afternoon.
On a more somber note, singer Kuhara was found dead last night at her home in Seoul.
Sulli entered the Korean entertainment when she was just 11. In 2009, she made her debut with K-pop girl group FX. They became one of the biggest K-pop girl groups. But just a year later, Sulli took a break. Wanna know why? On July 25th, SM Entertainment announced on FX official page. Because she is suffering physically from her ailments and mentally from the malicious and untrue rumors that are spreading about her, Sulli has requested that she take a break from all entertainment activities. Those rumors were that Sulli and Choya were dating, after they've been spotted by a paparazzi, holding hands. Idols can't date because some fans are extremely possessive, and would do extreme things to the idols, and the company. And instead of the companies stop this behavior, they feed these toxic people with exactly what they want. A idol. Companies want money and more money and more money. They forget about the person behind the idol. When an idol starts dating, the company stocks go down. So companies started to have strict rules for the idols, like Rule 1, no boyfriends allowed. Rule 2, no talking to the opposite sex within your company. Rule 3, be prepared for the mental health of trainees must be terrible. Things seemed to collapse in 2014. Sulli was known to do things in the Sulli way. She posed pictures of her and Choeza on her Instagram, even when everyone already knew they were dating. She kept getting more and more hate comments. What really made her stand out was her outspokenness. No fear, Sulli was Sulli and she was not sorry for that. K-pop artists are called idols in Korea. That must be ideal, perfect people and performers at all times, even in their personal lives. Sulli insisted women should be free to dress as they pleased, and she was often criticized for not wearing a bra in public and posting pictures on Instagram of her without a bra. And from those pictures on, she was betrayed in the media as attention whore. The thing about Sulli's Instagram is that journalists in Korea know if they write an article about the weird things she's doing, there is enough dedicated antis that will guarantee them free clicks and comments. So they write articles about her every move, and the antis predictably flood the comments. Sulli was getting hate for her every move, and even when it was a fake news, no one cared. I hate these people so much that I want to fart on their faces. When I first posted a no bra photo, there was a lot of talk about it. I was scared and could have hidden, but the reason I didn't is that I want to change people's prejudices about that. Part of me also wanted to say, this isn't that big of a deal. She spoke out based on her own beliefs. These non-conforming, loud and bold, why female stars have to risk their entire career to be who they are. Sometimes behind those light sticks in the crowd, there are really dark people. What idols are not allowed to do is reveal the often toxic, manipulative, and inhumane circumstances behind the scenes that push some performers to extremes. Many artists don't speak about the abuses of the industry because they are afraid of being blacklisted from the industry. They feel powerless compared to the giants, and sometimes they can be betrayed by their fans. Something that people don't realize is that those artists are employees. Some trainees sign contracts that stipulate that if they quit, they have to pay back everything the program invested in them. Idols since very young start living away from family and friends. They're forced to work 12 hours a day or longer, memorizing lyrics and dance moves, practicing until they don't make a mistake. Payment comes in the form of a room and dance and voice lessons, and sometimes even when they debut, things don't get better.
수입이 아니라 그냥 전체 수입이 42만 원이고 2월에는 조금 더 감사하게 96만 원이더라고요. 그래서 이렇게 어렵게 아티스트 생활을 하고 있으니까 여러분들이 또 상금을 주시면 되게 감사하겠는데 이게 상금이 없기 때문에 제가 이걸 팔아야 될 것 같습니다. 그래서 지금 이 상품을 보시면 굉장히 인테리어로서도 훌륭한 메탈릭한 디자인에
준비된 50만 원을 역사적인 현장입니다. 무대 위에서 한국 제주음악상 트로피가 현찰로 거래되고 있습니다.
Mental health still a taboo in South Korea, so many companies don't pay attention to it. And if you still think this is not a problem, these are the well-known names since 2005. On February 22, 2005, actress Lee Yoon-ju died by suicide at the age of 24. Sulli has something special. In South Korea, mental illness is a taboo, even within a family. Over 90% of suicide victims could be diagnosed with a mental disorder, but only 15% of them received proper treatment. Over 2 million people suffer from depression annually in South Korea, but only 15,000 choose to receive regular treatment. Sulli only released two songs after leaving FX. Dayfly with Dean. And Goblin. Both songs are about mental health. She was scrutinized by the industry, but never stayed quiet. She kept doing things in the Sulli way. And after headline, cyberbullying, harassment, mean comments, fake news. After an entire industry trying to kill her soul. They did it. Sulli participated in a show called The Night of Hate Comments. In an episode, Sulli apparently confessed that she had been feeling very empty in her life and that she had been lying to everyone by pretending to be happy. She said, "My life is actually empty, so I feel like I'm lying to everyone by pretending to be happy on the outside. I asked around a lot for advice. They told me, everyone has a dark side in their lives but they live pretending that they don't. Don't think of it as weird." Shin Dong-yup shared that he once asked when she was her happiest in her life, and she replied, "I've never really felt happy." He said she must have suffered so much if this young person said she'd never felt happiness. She's one of the few famous and outspoken Korean figures that openly talks about feminism, mental disorders, and body positivity. Young female stars, often in their teens, must dance in skimpy miniskirts or school uniform lookalikes, feeding the sexual fantasies. But when it comes to a solo artist's Instagram post, she suddenly becomes an attention whore, an idol performs as a sexual object but must pretend sex doesn't exist. After she died, some journalists interview some of the cyber bullies of Sulli. They said things like, "If you a public figure you should be so weak when it comes to comments," and, "I didn't thought she was hurt by my comment but if you famous you need to deal with this comments," and also, "I don't care, maybe she shouldn't be famous if she is a weak spirit. This video is for you, yes, you piece of shit." If there's one thing Sulli was not, was a weak spirit. People like you kill others in the daily basics. Before she went, she left one unique message for everyone. Stretch angels.